الحمد لله وحده وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We commence in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send peace and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Life is such that tests are inevitable. Life is such that every single one of us, in one way or another, must go through tests designed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah has designed something to happen in my life or in your life or in our lives, no one would be able to escape that thing. Such is the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no reason to stress whenever Allah tests a person, because Allah only tests those whom He loves. So if Allah doesn't love you, He won't even test you in the first place. And we learned, or we get this from the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ أَبْدَنِ بِتَلَاهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a servant of His or a worshipper of His, Allah tests them. So tests are such that nobody can escape them. Allah would surely test myself and yourselves, big or small. So what is expected from us is to always be prepared for the test that would be coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is either we pass those tests or we fail them. Subhanallah. It is either we pass the tests or we fail them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us be from those that would pass every single test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would test us with. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُم مُّصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَّبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ. We will surely test you with a little bit of fear, waljoo' and hunger, wanakasim min al amwal, and loss of wealth, wal anfus, and lives, wal thamarat, and fruits, farm produce, wa bashiri sabirin, but give glad tidings to those who have patience, to those who are patient. Alladhina idha asabatuhum musiba, قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Those whom when a disaster or a calamity befalls them, they say, indeed we belong to Allah and unto Him is our return. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Upon those are blessings and mercy from their Lord, and they are those who are rightly guided. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us. So wallahi, the tests of this life are such that nobody would be able to escape the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah has written something for you, you would surely come to witness that thing. Even if the whole world would come to prevent you from witnessing that thing, or to prevent that thing from happening, they wouldn't be able to. Why? Because Allah has written it, and it shall and must happen by the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same thing applies if Allah doesn't want something to happen. Even if the whole world would come together to make that thing happen, they won't be able to make it happen because it has not been decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it has not been decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why we need to live our lives by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe in Allah, we trust Allah, we rely upon Allah, we cry to Allah, we ask from Allah, and we complain to Allah, and we know we are here primarily to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would strengthen us in our iman, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make us pass the tests in a beautiful way. An amazing thing is, even those who are close to Allah cannot escape the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, I already said Allah only tests those whom He loves. So it's amazing how even someone who is pious, someone who is close to Allah, they won't escape the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah would test them in so many ways, big or small, subhanallah. And when the tests come, wallahi, it's only Allah that can make it easy. But not their taqwa, nor their knowledge would be able to help them except the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Except what? The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us. So wallahi, be prayerful and keep asking Allah to help you. Keep asking Allah to protect you. Keep asking Allah to strengthen you. Keep asking Allah to protect you from the trap of shaitan. Shaitan the accursed, when he plays his games, not everybody will be able to escape. Subhanallah. He made the Prophet Adam alayhi salam fall. Do you think myself and yourselves would be able to escape his games? Yes, we would be able to by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but not by our own power or by our own knowledge or what we know. And when we fall, we would immediately come back to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We would immediately come back to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I was saying, a pious person wouldn't be, you know, wouldn't say he wouldn't face the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How does Allah test them? Different types of tests could come to them. Wallahi, so many people, you look at those who are pious, Allah can test you from different angles. Someone who is a hafiz of the Quran or who is a da'i, he spreads good knowledge, mashallah, and he calls people to Allah. Allah tests him in one way. What way? Maybe Allah tests him with too much love for wealth, in a way that his money comes from a means that is not halal. How do you know? You might not know, but he knows. And that's going to be between him and Allah. And he would be constantly asking the forgiveness of Allah, that Allah forgives him. But he knows that that is a test from Allah, and that is his own weakness. That's just an example. How again could Allah test someone who is pious? Allah could test a pious person with the love for women. Doesn't it happen? It happens. Someone who is a da'i calling people to Allah, Allah tests them with love for women. Or with women loving him. And so it becomes a battle between him being focused, between him continuing to spread the deen or to call people to Allah, and on another hand, women are chasing after him. So it's either he protects himself with the help of Allah, or he might even fall. It's all part of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the most important thing I'd say is, it's not about falling alone, but realizing that you've fallen and making an intention to change and not being happy with the falling that you engaged in or the sin that you engaged in, and realizing that this is a test from Allah, and getting up and carrying on with your life and constantly asking Allah to forgive you. It does happen. Someone who is a da'i, women chase them. Am I right or wrong? I think we know these things. Women will chase them, right? They want them, they want to marry them, all these things, they come up, you know, social media and stuff, you know, sometimes real life, and all these things happen. So it could be from both sides. Maybe he wants, they want. Maybe he doesn't want, they want. Or they don't want, he wants. This is all part of the test of life, especially for someone who is close to Allah. And I want to tell you a secret. When Shaitan wants to make you fall, he would try to locate what your weakness is, and he would use your weakness to make you fall or sin against Allah, especially if you are someone who really fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Shaitan knows that you are someone who is fearing Allah, doesn't care that much about women, he won't even come from that direction, because he knows nothing is really going to happen. He don't care. So he won't come from that. He would come from your weakness. What is your weakness? Maybe money. So Shaitan would come to you through money. And if your weakness is women, he comes through women. Whatever your weakness is, he would come from that angle, because he desperately wants you to fall and sin against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is only Allah that can protect you. And when you eventually happen to fall, it is part of the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is part of the decree of Allah. So don't be too sad. Seek the forgiveness of Allah and continue to carry on with your life. Continue to carry on with your ibadah or your da'wah or whatever you are into. Don't stress too much. Don't bother too much. The Anbiya alayhim as-salam were all tested. Different types of tests. The Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was tested. Right? We know the story, what happened during his time. Different types of tests. Subhanallah, we know what happened, right? So look how it was indeed a test from Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us, really. The Prophet Musa alayhi salam was tested. The Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was tested. The Prophet Nuh alayhi salam was tested. Idris alayhi salam was tested. Ayyub alayhi salam was tested. Subhanallah. Yunus was tested.
وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَلَّن نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ.
الله أكبر. So the Prophet Yunus alayhi salam was tested. Look at this beautiful ayah. وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَلَّن نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. When the noon, the companion of the fish, left off or went off in anger, thinking that nothing shall be decreed upon him. فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ. After all, the event, eventually he called out to Allah in the darkness, is saying, Allah ilaha illa anta subhanak, there is none worthy of worship besides you, Allah. Subhanak, glorified are you. Inni kuntu min az-zalimin, indeed I was from among the wrongdoers. And amazingly, how this ayah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has taught us that anyone who calls out to Allah saying, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min az-zalimin, if you call out to Allah with this powerful, beautiful dua, whatever you've been asked shall be granted. It's a powerful dua. So the prophets of Allah were all tested. They were tested. So don't fret if you get tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, nobody is happy to sin against Allah. Nobody wants to sin against Allah, of course. And then we know how a person feels the pain, the hurt, or the heat that is there when you sin against the one who made you, and you are feeling so sad and you wish you can, you know, turn back time and erase everything or readjust everything, but you won't be able to, because it is part of the decree of Allah that that thing must happen. You can't prevent it from happening. So accept the reality and move on. Allah will surely test you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. And you know what? Don't laugh at people who are sinning against Allah. Don't laugh at people who are being tested by Allah. Otherwise, haha, Allah would come for you in a way that He would test you with a similar test, and you might fail the test even bigger or more than how they failed the test. Because you are laughing at them. You're not praying for them. You see people engaging in adultery or zina, the first thing is, ha, you're laughing, these guys, they don't know what they're doing, they're going to hell. Ha, you're just laughing and saying things. Yes, what they are doing is wrong. But have you thought about it from the side of if it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So what do? You advise them or you pray for them? The Prophet was never like that. He never used to laugh at people who were sinning against Allah or people who were non-Muslims at some point or stages in their lives. He never laughed at them. He always had hope for them. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he always had hope for them. We look at his life, we see the hope he always had for his people. He won't laugh. He would make beautiful dua for them that Allah guides them. Allahumma hdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. If you look at the story of what happened between him and the people of Taif, he made the beautiful dua for them. Oh Allah, guide them, for they don't know. If they knew, they wouldn't do all they did. It's out of misguidance. They don't know. That's why they did what they did. He didn't say punish them, destroy them, whatever, whatever. He made dua, Allah guides them. So that's how we are supposed to be. Have hope. Let's have hope for our fellow brothers and sisters. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would answer our du'as and He would guide them with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if we are going to be laughing and scoffing at them, then that is something that is bad. That is not what is expected to be seen from us as Muslims who are brothers and sisters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen us. So life is definitely a test. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us, big or small. So be ready for the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come at any time. And when those tests come, you know, ask Allah to make them easy for you in a way that you pass and you learn lesson. Like I said, yes, don't laugh at people, because that's how it can come back to you, especially those who are pious. You're laughing at them, Allah would test you, and to your surprise, you would fail the test. Subhanallah, you might just fail the test. Nobody would know. It's something private. You know what you did. It's between you and Allah. But you know personally the person. And you would realize, yeah, I used to laugh at these people, and all of a sudden, look at where you are, you know. Then you realize your mistake and you improve. Yes, you improve. There's plenty stories of people, you know, scholars or ulama who've gone through the similar tests. When the things would happen like this, you know, they would keep talking about something. These guys, they're doing this, and they keep swearing them or cursing them and this or that. And at the end of the day, they would come, the test would come upon them, and they will fail the test. And, you know, he would know he failed the test, and even his own students would know what happened to their sheikh, and they would understand. So the lesson would be for him and for them also. But it's part of the, you know, decree of Allah. For if Allah makes you go through a test and He allows you realize, you know, the mistake, and makes you realize indeed you've sinned against him and you repent and you carry on and move on, alhamdulillah. If you die upon that without seeking the forgiveness of Allah, then there is a big crisis. What's gonna happen? Subhanallah. That's why it's important, you know, they say what? Jihadun nafs. Your own self, you start with yourself primarily. Who are you? What's your relationship with Allah? You know, you might come out and call Allah, call Rasul in the masjid or masajid, but your own relationship with Allah is absolutely important. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen us and increase us in iman, protect us from shaitan and his trap, and make every single test we shall go through be easy for us with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness and his guidance, and let's know that we would only fall if you really fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Really, really fear Allah. You know, if you fear Allah and you still fall, you tried all your best to see that you don't fall. You know, sometimes when the test is coming, you can see something is chasing you. A lady, a woman is chasing you, for example. You know, someone who fears Allah, you see it coming. You trying your best to stop it, to block it. Whatever you do at the end of the day, you know, something happened. Well, you tried all you could, but maybe there is a lesson Allah wants you to learn. It still happened. Seek the forgiveness of Allah and move on with your life. Don't be bothered by the past sins or the previous sins. What happened in the past is gone. It's forgiven. You know, let's move on and let's carry on. By the way, you are not the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are not perfect. You are not infallible. You will fall. You know, the children of Adam, the hadith says, the children of Adam make mistakes, and the best from among them who make those mistakes are those who constantly repent, those who seek the forgiveness of Allah. So you are not perfect. The most important thing is you come here to worship Allah, you die upon iman, and inshallah you get Jannah. You have a good ending. Allahumma inni as'aluka husna al-khatima. Oh Allah, I ask you for a good ending. Khalas. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and strengthen us in our iman, and you know, grant us closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ultimately grant us Jannatul Firdaus. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanakallahumma rabbana wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa